I welcome you in part 3 of our history lesson, Evolution of Mankind. In previous two parts, we have discussed about Homo habilis and then we discussed about Homo erectus. Today, I'll be discussing with you the new species of human, that is Homo Neanderthal. So, if you look at the word Homo, I have told you already what is mean by Homo. Homo means human or man. And then how the Neanderthal word has came. So you can see the image of Neanderthal man, how he used to look like. And this species of human have got this name because there is one place in Germany, the country Germany, there is one place called Neanderthal, and their remains and their evidences of Neanderthal man has found here. So this species has got the name Neanderthal because the evidences of this type of man's are found in Neanderthal, a place in Germany. So I hope you have understood what is the word meaning Homo Neanderthal. And as I told you, these evidences are found in the country called Germany. And Neanderthal is a place in Germany, and here the fossils and the skeletons and other evidences are found. So this type of human species have got this name. So there are certain physical characteristics of these type of human beings, or we can say biological features of this type of human beings. So if you compare Homo Neanderthal man with Homo habilis and Homo erectus, you will find that these men were big and strong. Okay, they were very strong, physically strong. So Neanderthal man was physically strong, and the brain was more developed as compared to earlier species of humans like Homo erectus and habilis. So these people were strong, physically strong, and their brain was more developed if you compare with Homo habilis and erectus. And they were intelligent than Homo habilis also and Homo erectus. And these people were mostly living in groups, and they were spending time in the caves. Okay, so such type of tools, stone tools, they had created. You can see that these stone tools have become more sharper as compared to Homo erectus. It means as the man was developing, or his brain was developing, the change was happening in everything. Like the tools were changing, the food was also changing. So these people are making more sharp and more small stone tools as compared to the earlier human species. So you can see here that these stones have become more sharp because they come to know how to make it more sharp, as they were intelligent as compared to other human species. Then there are certain evidences which tell that when the dead person was buried that time, suppose any group member from the Neanderthal family used to die. So what they used to do? They used to bury that person. And how they used to bury? They used to keep some things along with the dead bodies. They used to keep tools which were used by the man or which are useful for the man, like some stone tools, some pots and other material which were useful for a man. Okay, so we have got, the scientists have got the evidences, like they used to keep some tools along with the dead bodies. Some horns of the animals are also found along with the dead bodies of Neanderthal. And before burying, they used to apply some kind of cream on the dead bodies. Red orchards they used to apply on the dead bodies. So that was the tradition that was done with the dead bodies. So these people used to bury the dead bodies along with the some tools, some weapons, some horns of the animals are found along with the dead bodies, and some other stone tools are also found. And what was the food of Homo Neanderthal? So these people come to know about how we can use fire to roast the meat, and they started cooking. Okay, though they did not have sufficient spices, but they used to roast the meat. And what was the advantage of roasting meat for them? As the taste was changing, it was easy for them to digest, and their brain was getting, or they were getting more time to think. Earlier, Homo habilis and erectus were eating most of the time raw meat. So it was taking time for them to chew, to digest the food. But as these people were roasting the meat and the flesh, so they were getting time to think and invent new things. Along with the roasted meat, these people used to have fruits in their diet. They even different types of nuts they used to eat. Then roots of the plants, edible plants. And they used to cook the meat, I told you already. So they used to cook or the roast, most of the time they used to roast it on the fire. And these people have migrated from one place to the other. I told you that these people were mostly found in Germany and Europe. But as the climate was changing, these people were also migrating from place to place. They were going in the other areas. Okay. And they started traveling towards Asia, Europe, Africa. And during this during their travel, they could not adjust with the changing climate, and most of them were dying, and they could not adapt the changing atmosphere, and they could protect themselves from the cold atmosphere because they were living in the caves, and along with this they were wearing leather clothes that also was protecting them from the cold atmosphere, and the fire was also used. So this was making them or keeping them warm. These were the useful things that proved very helpful to them survive in the harsh condition, cool conditions. Okay, so we have discussed about Homo Neanderthal. I will have a quick revise of the topic. These people were found in the country called Germany. Their evidences are found in the country Germany. Because of that, they have got this name. Then these people were mostly living in the groups, and they were living in the caves. They started fire use. They were roasting the meat, and even they had the burial system. What I told you about, once the person is dead, he was used to bury along with the some things like tools, weapons, and some horns of the animals. and these were big and strong as compared to earlier species, and intelligent also as compared to others previous species. Here's a video about Homo Neanderthal, so let's watch it.
Neanderthals are often depicted as brutish cavemen, but science shows that our early ancestors were actually quite advanced. Neanderthals, or Homo neanderthalensis, are our closest relatives in the human family tree. The species lived from about 400,000 to 40,000 years ago and inhabited an area that stretched as far west as Europe's Atlantic coast. And
so this man has more names, like Homo Neanderthal is the name. Along with this, Homo neanderthalensis is one more name, and Cro-Magnon man. These are the names which are given to Homo Neanderthal.
As far east as Central Asia. Their habitat reached northward to modern-day Belgium, making them the first humans to survive a cold glacial ecosystem. The North's cold environment may have influenced Neanderthals' physique. Their bodies were relatively short, with males averaging 5 feet 5 inches and females 5 feet 1 inch tall. And they were stocky, with broad chests, bulky torsos, and muscular limbs. These adaptations helped Neanderthals generate and retain body heat. Also, their noses were large and had relatively high bridges. This created a nasal chamber that warmed and humidified the cold, dry air they'd breathe in northern regions. Apart from adaptations that helped Neanderthals survive a harsh wintry habitat, the species also developed large brains. They were similar in size to modern humans' brains and were often larger. An increase in brain size may have played a significant role in another type of adaptation, culture. Culture is indicative of an intelligent species, and archaeological evidence suggests that Neanderthals had a relatively sophisticated culture. They built shelters, made and wore clothing, and created advanced tools. In fact, they were the first human species to make tools out of bone, not just stone. They also created objects that served ornamental purposes. Neanderthals are suspected to be the first humans to carry out the symbolic gesture of burying their dead and adorning gravesites with flowers. Neanderthals may have also created what may be the world's oldest cave art, which was found in Spain. Despite advances in their culture, sometime after 40,000 years ago, Neanderthals mysteriously disappeared. Some scientists believe the Neanderthals were killed or outcompeted by modern humans, or Homo sapiens, who arrived in Europe at around the same time as the Neanderthals' extinction. However, another theory suggests that Neanderthals mated with modern humans and were absorbed into the humans' much larger population. That may explain why most people of European or Asian descent have 1 to 2% Neanderthal genes in their DNA. For more than 150 years, Neanderthals have perplexed anthropologists. The first Neanderthal fossil specimen was discovered in Belgium in 1829 by Philippe Charles Schmerling. However, it wasn't officially classified as Neanderthal until decades later. The first fossil to be recognized as Neanderthal and as an early human or genus Homo fossil was found in 1856 by Quarrymann in Germany. The new species was named Neanderthalensis after the area where the fossils were found, Neander Valley. Neanderthals' fossils tell us how evolution built them to be sturdy to survive their harsh environment. But their tools, art, and DNA tell us that their resilience also involved innovation, creativity, and social behavior, much like Homo sapiens today.
Few more things I will add about Homo Neanderthal. Like these people, they used to communicate with each other. They used to talk with each other, but they have not developed a fixed language that is being used today. They used to shout and grunt. There is one word called grunt, G-R-U-N-T. So they used to grunt, they used to shout at each other in a different way. Suppose they are afraid, so they used to make a particular sound so that other member of the group used to become alert. And even they have developed a few symbolic languages which were useful for them. Okay, and at last, how they got extinct, why they were not found afterwards, they migrated from the places I told you. In that migration, they could not survive in the cold atmosphere. This is one reason for their extinction, why they got died or they are not found. And the other reason is that at the same time, there were Homo sapiens in some of the areas. So they had conflict with each other. They had fight with each other, and in that fight, Homo sapien won. They won the fights and they could win the against Homo Neanderthal. So there may be a question asked to you. So how, why and how the Homo Neanderthal got extinct? So I have told you how these people got extinct. They got extinct because of these two reasons which I told right now. Okay, so as you can see, these changes are happening in the human beings and they are becoming more and more advanced. Their brain is developing, then they are becoming more intelligent and more comfortable life they are trying to live. Okay, so I hope this much is enough.